All right, take 10. I'm not kidding. This is take number 10. As I've said umpteen times, there are three global systems and two local systems. The three global systems are the global pressure belts, the global surface winds, and the global upper air currents, the jet stream, in other words. The two local systems are the local pressure systems and the local wind systems. There are, in the Northern Hemisphere, six major local pressure systems. As you're about to see, they're really regional systems. It's not like local, like around the block, but they don't operate globally. Here's who they are: the Pacific High, the Aleutian Low, the Canadian High, the Icelandic Low, the Siberian High, and the Azores, also known as Bermuda High, depending on which side of the Atlantic Ocean you're on. We begin with the Pacific High. The Pacific High is the Eastern Pacific's branch of the subtropical high. Remember, we are on the western side of North America, but the eastern side of the Pacific Ocean. The Pacific High is the most consequential system for the weather and the climate in the state of California in general, and Southern California in particular. Here's why. During the winter, as you can see now on the left-hand side, the left-hand map, the Pacific High drags south following the center of heat on Earth. Remember from the first section of this class, during our Northern Hemisphere winter, the subsolar point is in the Southern Hemisphere. That also means the center of heat on the planet is in the Southern Hemisphere, which drags all of the pressure belts south, including the Pacific High. What this allows to happen is the westerly winds, because they come out of the northern end of the Pacific High, can now drag over the top of California. If you recall from before, the westerly winds are found from 35 to 55 degrees. Los Angeles is at 34 degrees north. Well, when the Pacific High heads south, it allows for whatever storms there are out in the Pacific to get caught in the westerly winds and drag over California. This is our winter wet season. During the summer, the Pacific High is shoved north because it follows the center of heat. During our summer in the Northern Hemisphere, the subsolar point is in the Northern Hemisphere. That means the center of heat on the planet is in the Northern Hemisphere, which pulls all of the pressure belts north. You can see what happens by looking at the diagram on the right-hand side. The Pacific High then ends up sitting right over the state of California, which prevents us from getting precipitation. But you can see at the same time, out of the northern end of the Pacific High, the westerly winds still drag across the continent. They just drag across up over the top of Oregon and Washington. The Aleutian Low, which is centered over the Gulf of Alaska, is the second most important and most consequential system for California. This is the Northern Pacific's branch of the subpolar low. The Aleutian Low generates our cold winter storms. Now, cold storms might bring snow to our mountains, but remember, cold air does not hold a lot of water. Therefore, we generally don't get a lot of precipitation out of storms generated from the Aleutian Low. Here's what happens. Of course, low pressure rotating counterclockwise in the Northern Hemisphere, you can see that the air rotates out of the southern end of the Aleutian Low, gets caught in the westerly winds, and then drags across the continent. During the winter months, when the Pacific High is pulled south, that allows for the storms generated by the Aleutian Low to drag over the top of California as they're pulled in by the westerly winds. However, during the summer months, when the Pacific High is shoved north, the westerly winds are shoved north, and those storms go further north up over the top of Oregon, Washington, British Columbia, Canada. Take a look at this, where the Pacific High and the Aleutian Low are operating together. From October to March, when the Pacific High pulls south, that allows the storms in the Aleutian Low to get caught in the westerly winds, represented by the red arrow, which drags over the top of California. But during the summer, from April to September, notice what happens. The winds are shoved north because the Pacific High goes north, and we in California are not going to get those cold storms. Next is the Canadian High. This is centered over central Canada during the winter because Canada sits out in the middle of a continent. Hudson Bay generally freezes, which makes it act like land during the winter months. And because of the continental influence in central Canada, it gets very cold during the winter, minus 20, minus 30, minus 40, even minus 50 degrees, which causes subsiding air and creates a high pressure system. This very cold, dry air occasionally slides into the United States, bringing very cold conditions during the winter months. Next is the Icelandic Low. Guess where that's at? Correct. It sets up over Iceland. This is the Northern Atlantic's branch of the subpolar low. While it does not have a lot of influence over the United States, this is the primary system that creates the cool, moist climate of the British Isles, Northern Germany, and Scandinavia. And then during the winter months, it brings cold, wet storms across the European continent and into North Africa. The Siberian High, like the Canadian High, is a winter system. Canada's pretty big. Asia is significantly bigger. Asia is the biggest continent on Earth, and much of it is very far north. Because of that, during the winter, it becomes exceptionally cold there. Minus 40, minus 50, minus 60, even minus 70 happens out in Central Asia during the winter months, primarily in Siberia, but also Mongolia. Cold air subsides, which creates the Siberian High during the winter. As you can see with the arrows, this generates an offshore flow of air during the winter months in Asia. The last of our systems is the Azores, also known as Bermuda High. This is the Central Atlantic's branch of the subtropical high. Whether it's known as Azores or Bermuda High depends on which side of the ocean you're on. If you're on the European African side, it's called the Azores High. If you're on the American side, it's generally referred to as the Bermuda High. It sits right there in the Central Atlantic. It's very important because of this. Tropical storms are generated along the western side of Africa, especially in the late summer and throughout the fall. Those storms then migrate into the Atlantic Ocean, and because of the clockwise circulation of that high pressure system, they get caught in the trade winds, the tropical easterlies. Then they're dragged across the Atlantic Ocean. As they do that, they pick up lots of energy from the hot ocean. As they do that, they sometimes turn into hurricanes. And as you can see by the arrow, those hurricanes then can affect the Caribbean and the eastern seaboard of the United States.